I hate smartphone companies putting bloatware apps on their phone, and I know you hate it too. Even though we don't need these apps, removing them is hard. So in this video, let's see how we can easily remove these bloatware apps from our smartphones. For those who don't know what bloatware apps are, these are the unwanted apps that comes pre-installed on your Android device and you cannot uninstall them. But the good news is that you can easily remove these apps using ADB. Now, you may wonder what is ADB. In short, ADB stands for Android Debug Bridge, and with the help of this tool, you can communicate with your Android device. You can connect your Android device to ADB via USB or wirelessly using TCP connection. We will be using this TCP connection to uninstall apps via ADB without PC. But before that, let's see how we can do that with PC using USB. So first, you need to install ADB in your PC. For that, simply search SDK platform tools on Google and click on the first result, that is from developer.android.com. And from here, download SDK platform tools for your Windows or for Mac or Linux. I will be downloading it for Windows. Just accept this agreement and click on download Android SDK platform tools for Windows. And this will download SDK platform tools. As you can see here, could not download network issue. Let's try it and it is completed. And after it is downloaded, you will see this zip file. So what you have to do is simply extract this here. I will simply unzip it here. After it is unzipped, I will see ADB. See? adb.exe. Now you can simply open a terminal here by clicking on open in terminal. After that, you can type ls to list all the files in this directory, and here is our adb.exe. We can run it by typing /adb.exe, and this will run ADB. So this is how you can install ADB in your PC. It is so simple. Now that we have installed ADB in our PC, it's time to open our phone and turn on USB debugging. So for that, go to your About Phone section and then click on your build number, or for MIUI, click on this MIUI version multiple times and you will be developer. As you can see, now it says you are now a developer. After you are a developer, go to developer settings by just searching developer options. And from here, what you need to do is to turn on USB debugging. See, this is the button. I will turn on USB debugging. And after that, if you are prompted with anything like this, just click on I'm aware of possible risk and click on OK. And this will turn on USB debugging. Now that we have enabled USB debugging, connect your phone to your PC. Now that we have connected our phone to PC, type this command /adb.exe and then shell. Hit enter and you will find a notification on your phone to allow USB debugging. So click on OK to allow USB debugging. Daemon started successfully. That means we have successfully connected to our phone via ADB. Now that we are inside our phone, you can do PM list packages, PACKAGES, to list all the applications that are installed in your phone. As you can see here, this is a list of all the packages that are installed in my phone. As you can see, we are not seeing the name. It is the package name, like com.google.android.apps.restore. So first, you need to find out the package name of the app that you want to uninstall. For that, what you can do is to install this APK extractor application from Play Store. And after that, if you will open this application, it will load all the applications that are installed. You can search any installed application here. I will search get apps, and as you can see here, com.xiaomi.mipix, the package name is written below the app name. Now that we know the package name of the app that we want to remove, type pm uninstall. We need to remove it, so uninstall, and after that -k --user0. And then the package name. To remove get apps, the package name is com.xiaomi.mipix. So I will simply type it. This is the package name of the get apps application. If I will hit enter, this will remove get apps application from my phone. As you can see here, success. This means the application has been successfully removed. I no longer see get apps application in my phone. That means it has been successfully uninstalled. If you accidentally uninstall some important system APK, you can reinstall it by typing this command pm install, I-N-S-T-A-L-L, install dash existing, E-X-I-S-T-I-N-G, existing, and after that the package name. For example, if I want to reinstall this GetApps application, I need to type its package name, that is com.xiaomi.mepix, and this will install this GetApps application again. And now in my phone I can see GetApps application again, but I don't want it, so I will simply remove it. So this is how you can remove pre-installed apps with the help of PC using ADB without rooting your phone. Now let's see how we can do this without PC and without root. So for that I will be using different phone, cause my phone does not support ADB wirelessly. So the first thing will be to enable USB debugging. For that you can get inside the settings and then about phone and then click on build number multiple times. And now I'm a developer, it needs me to enter my mobile pin, and here we go. Now I'm a developer. So let's just search developer options, and from here enable USB debugging. As you can see, I have enabled the USB debugging, and below that you will see there is wireless debugging. So enable that too. Debug mode when Wi-Fi is connected. So enable it. And now as you can see, it is saying allow wireless debugging on this network, the network that I have connected. So I will simply allow this, and the wireless debugging is enabled. Now you will need Termux application. But before that, this wireless debugging is only available above Android 10. So if your phone is on Android 11 or 12, you can use wireless debugging. My Poco was on Android 10, so I needed to use USB connection for that ADB. And this phone is on Android 12, so we can use wireless debugging. Now that we have enabled wireless debugging, you will need another application, that is Termux. In this Termux application, we will be installing ADB, and then with the help of that ADB, we will be connecting to our phone and then uninstalling the apps that we want to install. And we will be installing this Meet application. As you can see here, I cannot uninstall it. There is only one option, that is to disable this application. Important note, do not download this Termux application from Play Store. I will provide a link in description, or you can simply download it from F-Droid by searching on Google, because the Play Store version is outdated. So after you have installed your Termux, simply just open it, and this is how it will look like. Here, first we need to type this command to update all the list of packages. Make sure to type this command or else you won't be able to install ADB. Now that we have updated the list of available packages, it's time to install ADB. So for that, type apt install android, android android-tools, and then click do you want to continue, type y for yes, and this will install Android tools which contains ADB. Now that Android tools is installed, if you will type ADB and you will see something like this, that means your installation is successful. Now if you will type ADB devices, devices, this ADB will automatically try to connect to your device. As you can see, if I will hit enter, it is asking me allow USB debugging, the computer's RSA key, fingerprint and something like that. So simply click on always. You can also do always allow from this computer, and simply click on allow, and now you have successfully connected. Now let's see ADB devices again. We can see our device, that is emulator 554. Now you can type ADB shell to get inside shell, and here we are in this shell. Now if I will do PM list packages, I can see the packages PACKAGES. These are all the packages that are installed in my phone. Rest of the steps are same. To uninstall anything, you can type PM UNINSTALL uninstall dash k dash dash user 0 and then the package name. So for that Meet, we are going to use apk extractor to see its package name, and then let's search for Meet. Here it is, com google.android.apps.tachyon. How should I pronounce this? Tachyon. Now let's type it here, T-A-C-H-Y-O-N, and it should uninstall Google Meet from this phone. And if I will hit enter, it is success. That means it has been uninstalled. And now if I will see here, I can no longer see Meet application. That means it has been uninstalled. So this is how, with the help of ADB, you can uninstall pre-installed packages without PC or with PC. So that's it for this video. Hit that like button. I will see you in the next one.